Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Along the Shore. Today, we are going to do a little project on the very back page. Now, I've done some prep for this because I wanted to sew around this. So, you can see my shiny thread, and I did some stitching around the corner. I think it shows up on camera, but it kind of looks like a shell. So because that was going to take such a long time, I wanted to do it beforehand because this is just going to be a big, huge pocket. Now it's going to go on the back page like this here. So I will glue around the three sides. There'll be a pocket in the top. I originally wanted a pocket here, but because of what I'm going to put here, I can't do that. So then I've got this flip pocket. Now these are made out of, let me just grab the book here. I took those pages out of this Mermaid Coast paper pack that I got at Michael's long time ago. I don't even know when I got it. I just happened to find it in my stash. So I'm pretty sure I would have gotten it at Michael's. So, but I really like this paper. I love the colors. It goes together so well with this project. So it's going to go there. And these were big little panels that were in the paper pack. And I just really like them. So I'm going to make a flip right in the middle of this. So then that's going to fold up like that. Now I don't want to see this. So my idea is I'm going to be cutting a slit in this pocket. And then I'm hoping that I don't wreck it. Here is my filthy dirty mat, cutting mat. So what I want to do, need my pencil. Now I want to put this on fairly even. I really love this clear stitching. I use this stuff here. It's a J.P. Coates product for its pearl colors 1001. But it's almost clear, but it's shiny, so it kind of picks up the color of whatever you've stitched it on, which is kind of nice. So let's center this. As I say, I want to cut a little slit, and I'm going to cross my fingers, because after doing all this sewing and stuff, I'm going to draw a line right from the end. Up. Right to the other end. Now, I don't want the hole to be big. I want it to be the exact right size. So then what I'm hoping is I can drop that right in there, so then I won't see the back. So let's hope. Okay, now I'm going to line up my ruler. This is a metal ruler, so I can cut with it. Let's line that up. I want to be able to see my line ends. And now I'm just going to use a razor knife. Concentrating on lining it up. Actually, let's put a little line. Can't see the ends of my line when the ruler's up against it. So I do the little lines in, because I do want to cut right on top of the line. Okay, keep your fingers crossed. Right to there. Now, did it cut all the way through? Well, for the most part, it did. Let's... trying to just get through my cardstock. Okay. How can you tell I haven't done this before? Okay, let's see how that did. Still not through, through a lot of it. Okay. As I say, I want to try to keep that as thin as possible. Let's... thought cutting a little hole like this would be this difficult. Sorry if I'm out of frame, but I'm trying to keep a good eye on where I'm at here. Okay. Now let's hope, keep our fingers crossed. I want this to fit right into there. Okay. That is going to work just like that. Let's get rid of this here mat. Okay, that's gonna work. Let's glue down this side here. I'm going to use Art Glitter Glue. And let's... I just filled my Art Glitter Glue up and the glue comes out really fast. Okay, so we've got that there. Let's... that down, and let's make sure that we've got that. Should have inked that, but that's okay. The ink kind of makes it so it doesn't stand out quite as much. Let's just erase our couple of little lines. Okay, I like that, and they go together nice, these two. I like. Okay, now I don't really need to keep this closed, because it's going to be like that in a book. Now, there's a pocket here, and then there's going to be a pocket behind there. Now, I have this here. It was on a necklace that I had. I was thinking about using a brad and mounting that as a bit of a closure. So then it'd be like that, and then you just turn it and it would open up. Because you could use this for writing or put something else there. But I thought this gold went really good with that. So let's... yeah, that'll work. Okay. Now, think about there. Okay, not sure if my cutters will go, or my hole punch will go that far. No, it won't. So let's just get this here, the awl, and let's poke that into there. Now, all the brads that I had didn't fit in there, but I thought, well, that one with the little blue kind of goes okay. It's one of the few brads that I had that would fit through that end. Let's do this. Now that's going to just sit like that in the journal and just twist and turn when we want it closed. Now I want to cover the back of this because I don't, when I slip something in the pocket, I don't want it to get caught. So I'm just going to use a piece. Not gonna see this anyways. So I'm just going to put that there. And I'm just gonna glue it around the edge because I don't want to glue the brad. But I guess it doesn't really matter because the brad doesn't need to turn. You can see on here how much this runs out. I'm not sure if the glue was a little bit runnier than it has been. But I bought like a big, I don't know what it was. 8 ounce bottle, and then I just use it for refills. Okay, there's that. So now when something gets slipped in there, it shouldn't get all hung up on there. So that goes like that. Just something a little decorative. It doesn't have to be over there that very much to hold it. I think that will be okay. Let's bring in our page. Now we're going to glue it down on the three sides. So let's get that done. Hold the top. Now I want to try not to get too much on here. And I'm trying to go on top of the stitches as well as a little bit on the paper. Want it to be held down fairly good. It's going to be a huge pocket. Not quite sure what we're going to put in it yet, but okay, that should be good. Let's flip that over. Try to get it as even as possible. That looks pretty good there. Let's glue it down. I'm really loving how this project is coming together. I've got some ideas for this here little piece there. Now, like I say, my original thought was to leave a pocket here at the end. But because of what I'm going to put there, it wouldn't work. So, okay, let's get this glued down. Whenever gluing down a piece that has the stitching on it, always is a little bit harder because the stitching keeps the stuff up in the air just that little tiny bit. So I always take a little bit extra time to make sure. So there we go. So we've got this. Flips open. You could even write all around there. And we'll make a big card for in the pocket, and we'll make a big card for in this pocket too. So now on the edge, I have this here. Now it was white like that there, and I took a few different colors of shimmer mist and I just sprayed it, just laid it on a piece of paper and sprayed it. I've got like a teal, a green. There's a bit of a gold, which you can't really see in there. But I just thought that was a nice piece of trim. I got it at the thrift store quite a while ago. And it just seems to be the perfect size for on here. Now, I want to, let's trim that right there. I'm going to put some glue right on the end there to hold that together while, even when it's in the book. Let's reach in my silicone brush here. And I can push it down without getting too glued up. I'll cut this after I've put it on here. Gotta decide how much glue I want to put down. Gonna put three lines of glue, a little bit bigger one in the middle. Let's even that up on the bottom. Okay. Just kind of lining it up with the edge. Ideally, I'd like to pin this down for a few minutes. But for the video, we'll just hold it. Okay, and then let's trim it right there. Okay, gonna have to go a little bit shorter. Let's try it this way. Okay. There we got that. And just want to glue this end a bit better. Just because it's right on the folds, so it's nice if we can I think that pretty is pretty. I thought these colors went so good with the rest of the journal when I sprayed it on there. So now when we get all this stuff put in here and it's closed, you will see that on the front of the journal. Still not sure what I'm doing with the front and the back yet. That will be my next project, is doing the front and the back, so stay tuned for that. But it's coming along pretty nice. We've got our big gatefold, our little flippy flappy thing, and then we've got our envelope, which was supposed to be a flip that turned into a page. We've got our big envelope. Beautiful center. Love this. Love, love, love. Then we've got our triple pocket. I did end up changing the mermaid to run this way instead of this way. I love how these pockets turned out. Our bag on the other side of our little envelope that was supposed to be a flip. We've got just kind of a plain page and our page with our shells and coral around it. And now the page that we just finished. She's looking pretty beautiful. So hope you're following along. There is a playlist for this journal build. We still have all the cards and tags and whatnot, plus the front and the back, and a couple little journals to go in it. So probably maybe 3 to 4 more videos before it's finished. Check out the Facebook group. You can get this Along the Shore digital kit on Ko-fi or on Etsy. We will see you soon in another video. Bye!